Palestinians commemorate Land Day, confronting what they see as the biggest threat to their land, symbols of Israel's occupation. Across the West Bank, Land Day was marked with dozens of activities, some far away from politics, like play days for children and family picnics. No longer just an expression of solidarity, Land Day for Palestinians in the occupied West Bank is also an expression of survival, like here in Beit Sahoor, where the residents feel increasingly threatened by the ever-encroaching Israeli settlements. With plows in hand, these activists and students from Bethlehem schools make a statement that's become the hallmark of Land Day, planting olives to stay where people can't.
They are taking it, and we have to prove it that this is our land by planting these trees here.
This area near Shepherd's Field is now under threat. An Israeli military watchtower stands tall, ensuring the fields of Ush al-Ghurab are off limits to Palestinian development.
Beit Sahoor in the north, there is a settlement, Jabal Abu Ghneim or Har Huma. And in the east, it's full of settlements. And it is the only point, the only place we can expand.
For Palestinians, this day is a reminder of the essence of conflict here. The land they feel is being swept from under their feet. And in the absence of a political horizon that can save it, Palestinians feel they must preserve the land one tree at a time. Nour Odeh, Al Jazeera, Beit Sahoor.